جان استیونسون رئیس هیئت رابطه با عراق در پارلمان اروپا. کنفرانس در مقر اروپایی ملل متحد 10 اسفند 91. معاون کوبلر در یک نامه طولانی از من می‌خواهد که با همکارانم از خانم رجوی بخواهیم ساکنان را متقاعد کند به ریل معمول مصاحبه ها بازگردند. گویا که هیچ حمله اتفاق نیفتاده است، انگار که 7 نفر به صورت وحشیانه کشته نشده اند، انگار که 10 نفر اعضای بدنشان را از دست نداده اند، انگار 90 نفر به طور جدی مجروح نشده اند. نصیحت امروز من این است که با مارتین کوبلر دیگر همکاری نکنید، دیگر برای مصاحبه های بیشتر با کمیساریا همکاری نکنید، اجازه ندهید که ویژه سازی شود و تنها 10 یا 20 یا 30 نفر به یک کشور امن برده شوند و در نتیجه این کار کسانی که میمانند بیش از قبل در معرض تهدید قرار گیرند. 3 هفته پس از آن حمله وحشیانه که این افراد را کشت، یک عدد کلاه خود و یا جلیقه ضد گلوله به لیبرتی راه داده نشده. به ساکنان حتی اجازه داده نشده که برای 7 سنگر انفرادی ویل بخرند. این افراد 3 بار مورد کشتار قرار گرفتند. آنها مورد آزار و اذیت قرار گرفتند. مایملکشان دزدیده شده. آنها را ربودند، کشتند، شکنجه کرده اند، از خدمات پزشکی محروم کرده اند. مزار عزیزان آنها در اشرف مورد بی‌حرمتی قرار گرفته و حالا ما در وسط اجلاس حقوق بشر نشسته ایم.
There is no question that this attack ordered by the mullahs in Tehran was coordinated by the Iraqi authorities from the highest possible office of Nouri al-Maliki himself. And there is no question at all that we have warned, as Mrs. Rajavi said in her speech repeatedly, that this was going to happen. This killing ground was prepared for this purpose. When Martin Kubler came to see me in my office in Brussels and to see other senior members of the European Parliament, he brought with him a large dossier of photographs to show us what a wonderful concept this Camp Liberty would be, that it was humanitarian, it was comfortable, they would be provided with complete security, albeit it was rather small, but they would only be there for a few weeks, and then they would be taken off to places of safety. Twice I came here to Geneva to speak to Antonio Guterres, and he told me that the concept was to have, in his words, a revolving door where several hundred people would be brought from Camp Ashraf to Camp Liberty, interviewed by UNHCR, registered as refugees, and immediately taken to countries of safety. And I went to Paris and persuaded Mrs. Rajavi to tell the people of Ashraf that this was their only chance of getting out of Iraq. They had to move to Camp Liberty. The UNHCR interviews could not be undertaken at Ashraf. It was a red line for Maliki and the Iraqi government. And against her better judgment, Mrs. Rajavi finally gave in to my insistence and spoke to the people in Ashraf and persuaded them to move. Based on the guarantees we had had from Martin Kubler, which now have proved to be completely false. I was deceived. The dossier of photographs had been doctored. We have that on first-hand evidence from Tahar Boumedra, who worked for the UN in Baghdad and resigned in disgust at being ordered to doctor these photographs. This is the behavior of the United Nations in Iraq. I was deceived, my colleagues were deceived, and in turn we deceived the people of Ashraf, forcing them to make themselves vulnerable targets of assassination and murder. And that is exactly what has happened now, and I feel guilty for that. Now, what do we see as a result? I got a very long letter yesterday from the deputy of Mr. Kobler, Mr. Buston, telling me that I must persuade all my colleagues, and he incidentally had copied this letter to about 20 of my senior colleagues in the European Parliament, that we must all tell Mrs. Rajavi to intervene now and persuade these people to continue to allow UNHCR to go on with the interviewing process and the registration process and to cooperate with them. Business as usual, as if no attack had taken place, as if 7 people had not been brutally killed, 10 people dismembered, 90 people critically injured, as if none of this had happened, despite all of our warnings. Let's return to business as normal. Please don't criticise my great friends in the Iraqi government. That would never do. And I can tell you, Mrs. Rajavi, that I advise today these people who have been deceived and deceived by me in the past, my advice to them today is stop cooperating with Martin Kobler. Stop cooperating with any further interviews with UNHCR. Do not allow cherry-picking so that 10, 20 or 30 people can be plucked out and taken to some country of safety, leaving those who remain behind even more vulnerable. Tell them there is no more business as usual. We must get these people out of Camp Liberty, where they are in imminent danger of annihilation, all 3,000 of them, and we must get them immediately to a place of safety. If that means temporarily getting them back to Ashraf, where because of its size and because of the concrete bunkers and buildings, they will be more safe while we find a way of getting all 3,100 of them out of Iraq 3 weeks after the vicious assault that killed these people. Not a single helmet or armoured vest has been allowed into Camp Liberty. They have asked permission to buy shovels so that they can dig bunkers in which they could hide if there's another missile attack. They have been refused permission even to buy shovels. No T-walls have been brought into the camp. And we are sitting here in the 22nd Human Rights Council of the United Nations in the Palais des Nations here in Geneva, sitting here, leaving these people, abandoning them to their fate. They have suffered 3 massacres. They have suffered harassment, abuse. They've been robbed, kidnapped, tortured, murdered, denied medical assistance. The graves of their loved ones have been desecrated in Ashraf. And we sit here in the middle of this human rights conference, abandoning them to their fate, on the basis of advice from Martin Kobler.